As a daughter fine and grand, perhaps she take it into her head for to marry an Irishman. And if I could only get the chance to have a word or two, I'm sure she'd take a notion in the bowl out on the hoo.
Her, I'm the boy to please her, and I'm the boy to tease her. I'm the boy can squeeze her, rock, and I'll tell you what to do. I'll court her like an Irishman at the broken barney too, with me flapping, me rollicking, spolligan, holligan, walligan, bowl out on the hoo.
But Marty got us a job at the Blue Angel, which is uptown New York. Now, that was big time, you know. I well remember the night that Marty said, you know, the talent scouts from the Ed Sullivan Show are coming tonight. And he said, you got to be really on your best behavior. And We did our regular show. We used to do Sam Hall, I remember. My name it is Sam Hall, it is Sam Hall. My name it is Sam Hall, and I hate you one and all. You're a bunch of muckers all, goddamn your eyes. Blast your souls, bloody hell, chorus, shit. And the headline act, a guy named, he was a comedian, Jackie something or other. He came down and he said, you guys had shit on the stage. Hey, you're the opening act. I'm the headline act. What am I going to do, come out and say fuck?
And now from the counties of Tipperary and Armagh, the thrilling voices of the Clancy brothers. Will the Clancys hold up their hands so I can distinguish you harps? And Tommy Makem. Tommy, you is the opposite, is the fourth. They're going to sing two wonderful Irish songs, and they are just sensational.
Somebody put a door open where nobody knew a door existed. It's hard to explain. We were one kind of people playing little folk clubs and doing small theatres and acting jobs. And suddenly, you get on the Ed Sullivan Show and your life is twisted around.
In Ireland, in a place called Castlemaine, he wants her, she is pretty, she is the belle of Belfast City, she is a 14-1-2-3, he will tell me your way, but give me enough of the fine old stuff that's made near Galway Bay. At the show, he'll see again.
Pace of life picked up in incredible rate. We were surrounded on the streets by people looking for autographs. It was like we were thrown into rubber rafts that go down the rapids. 9-10 years, there was no hope of getting out of that thing.
She won't tell them how when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, but it's all worth only two.
But from 1961, for about, I'd say, 15 years more, twice a year we did Carnegie Hall. We thought it was great fun. the fact that four greenhorn gobshites from Tipperary and Armagh should have all these people coming to see us and paying good money when they could have come down to the White Horse and heard us for nothing, you know? It just boggled the mind. As far as we were concerned, any given concert in there would be a brief interruption of the party that was ongoing.
Hello there. You know, there was a time in America when Irish immigrants, like the four of us here, had a sort of a rough time. That was before the... but, howsomever, this song is about some people who came and got a rather black welcome. I think all things considered, some of them didn't do too badly.
Our ship is docked in New York town, and we took our bags ashore. This was the land of the free, they said, we'd see hard times no more. But when we looked for work next day, wherever we'd appear, the boss so proud would shout out loud, we want no Irish here. We have loyal hearts and willing hands, of work we have no fear. But when we'd ask for a job, they'd say, we want no Irish here.
These songs didn't make any sense to the Irish American. It wasn't Danny Boy. It wasn't Tooraloo Loora. It wasn't Your Mother Comes From Ireland. It wasn't I'll Take You Home Again, Kathleen. And they didn't know what to make of it. It was a whole different culture.
And I hear the people are afraid, though, of losing their homes, and therefore the Conservative Party is very strong here, and there's even reports of Minutemen or IRA type.